Great here. Welcome back to Factorio. So, we haven't been attacked yet, which I'm surprised given how much we have floating around. Ooh, they've creeped closer, I think. We've got some bases up here, so I think we might be attacked today. I'm not entirely sure, but we'll deal with it when it happens. Until then, I am going to start working on my oil production. So, let's branch off some power. And these can go quite a distance. That's the nice thing about the big power poles is they go exceptionally far, but they have a very small power footprint at the bottom, as you can see. There we go. Okay, that's good enough for now. And I apologize for how dark it is. So, where's our pump jacks? How many do I need? I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 more pump jacks. Wow. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Let's run back and pick up some gears. Go. 6, 7, 8. There we go. And let's also make, while I'm thinking about it, where's my there's the tanks. Okay, so I want 4 tanks. And these poles can be locked there. So let's just start from the bottom. And get all of this hooked up. Jack there, and this one I'm actually going to do that there, and the reason for that is just so I can, you know, get a little bit, well, I mean, everything is just so crammed together. There we go. And 2 more. Actually, 1 more. There we go. Okay, so this one we'll do that way. And up here is where I want my tanks. I love how there's the fluid sound and there's nothing in there. Actually, it was silly of me to do this. Like I said, build backwards. Or in this case, forwards. Okay, bullet damage. Yes, please. Okay. So. Okay. A bit more pipes. Okay. So, let's just put an underground pipe here. Whoops, wrong direction. There, to say here. And then this is where we're going to have our 4 tanks worth of storage. Clear out some space. Okay, so I need to power all of this up. Can I reach? How far can I reach? I cannot reach, so I should just do one more right in the middle here. That'll get two of them going. And now I can use the medium poles from there. So where's... need more medium poles. That gets all of those. That gets there. And one more right here. Can I make it a loop? Yeah. There we go. Okay. So, just cramming a whole bunch of oil into this pipe. I actually do not want that there. I want one extra. You always want to have it one off, in case you want to put something else in here. Okay. So, this is going to generate a lot of pollution, which is going to head to the south. And this is also very expensive. So, let us gun up this place. In fact, can I build guns while I'm doing this? Yes, I can. And I want a whole bunch of guns. Not that I have a whole bunch of ammo on me. Okay, so this is where I want steel chests. In fact, I'm going to want a bunch of steel chests. And where's my guns? Guns, guns, guns. There we go. And it's dark! Let's go get more. I'm gonna need a ton of ammo. I also want to get a whole bunch of walls. Is this pollution? Oh. 1,000 expected resources. Okay. So, yeah, my iron is. My iron production is fine. Okay, so let us get all of our brick. Let us get all of our walls. And we need bullets. All the bullets. So what I'm going to do is I'm basically going to enclose this area down here. Basically, that's how paranoid I am about the pollution and how expensive that this is. So let's just get the walls up first, and then we'll worry about gun placement after that. And I'm not worried about the north side so much. And that's because anything that's going to attack from the north is going to hit my base long before it gets down here. There we go. Okay, let's get gates next. I'm going to want gates down here. And I want about out to here. There we go. Okay. So, let us get the guns down. I want a gun there. I want a gun there. Here and here. here. 1, 2, 3. And there. And here. 1, 2, 3. There. Okay. Let's continue with the walling. I think this is enough. Perfect. More guns. And let's see, that gets over to there. There. Okay. So the way that these corners work, so put the ammo box there. And then a medium pole right here. Okay, let's see. Let's get these placed first. I'll worry about the poles in a minute. I don't think I'm going to be attacked. Oh. That's what I get for trying to walk through pipe. And the distance placement here, you'll notice that the range of this gun actually covers the gun down there. Of course, if it gets attacked from the south, this won't reach, but at least it's got some coverage. For the level of the aliens right now, this is more than sufficient. This is like overkill, actually. Okay. So let's get our medium electric poles and just put them in every location. Okay, and now we need there. I should be able to get there. There. God, trying to go through those pipes again. There. Okay. And get the ammo in here. And I feel silly because I should have been building as many of those as I could. Okay, so that's got ammo. That's got ammo. See what I mean by I can just run past and see what chests, you know, what gun emplacements need ammo based off of the chest in the middle. And I really should have one up here, but I'm not too concerned about it. Light all the things. Because actually, this is where my gate is going to go. So I'll worry about that later. So now, what I want to do is I want to have this right here. This is going to build crude oil barrels. And we're going to rotate it this way. Put in a pipe there. So now we've got, look at that, half full. Oh, jeez. Okay, so we need an output and an input. We need power. Not that power. We need this power. Here. And here. Okay. What do we want next? Let's get... I don't want engines yet. I want plastics. Okay. So now, let's zoom in again. There's our input and our output. Wait, which one's the input? This one. Okay, bottom is input. Got it. Okay, so we put in crude or steel barrels. Comes in here, comes out as crude oil barrels. This is what we're actually going to be taking back to the base. What do I need for gates? Steel plates, of course. Okay. So, let's take all of these, and we will just do the poor man's gate. There we go. Whenever you're running in the wilderness, you always want to zoom out. Later on, when we get into trains, you want to see the trains coming from a long distance off, because they will kill you, like the bastards that they are. And here you can see biter attacks coming from a distance off. Speaking of, I can actually make my, there we go. Make my heavy armor. Okay, so for the time being, where am I going to put my oil processing? I think I'm going to put it right down here. That way this forest here can soak up all of the pollution that it's going to cause. Okay, let's put this in there. I need more circuits. And gears. Okay, look good. I look good. Okay, so let us make, I need 5 gates. Where are my gates? There we go. And I'm also going to make 5 panels, solar panels. These are only going to work during the day. Now the thing is say that power goes completely out. Where's my gate? There we go. Say that power goes completely out. I want these guns to still be loaded whenever. So I'm actually going to put some solar panels down here, because I have a lot of space that I'm never going to use for anything else. This is a great location just to throw some panels to help out with the power generation during... I don't want those there. To help out with the power generation during the day, and if there's a power outage, say aliens come through and they destroy this... this connection here. I have local power generation down here that will ensure that the guns will still be fed. You know what? I should actually put them in there. There. So now if I look at my power stats, I don't know how to get... Oh, there it is. 5 solar panels producing roughly 300 kilowatts. Time of day does affect their production. It goes up to noon and then back down at night. So this is now helping up... this is 300 kilowatts that my engines do not have to produce, which lowers my pollution footprint. Which is a very, very, very good thing. Yeah, I'm eventually going to tap into this copper field, so I don't want to put anything here, because I'll run it up here into, so yeah, oil production, right here. Let's get started. We need an oil refinery. Now, like I said, this is going to be janky as all, it's just going to be horrible. It really is. But the reason for that is because I'm rushing to robots. I want to get it done. I'll make it pretty later. In fact, where's my barrels? Where are barrels, barrels, barrels? Did I not pick up a bunch of... I used up all my steel. Good one. Okay, well, while I'm heading up to steel, I can at least place this. So... Yeah, let's put it on this side of the bus. I'm actually surprised I have not gotten attacked yet. The first time I went through this, I only got to oil on episode 14. There we go. And you were just going to do oil refinery. And the reason for that was because I got attacked way early. I mean, massively early. It was just frustrating. Yeah. Let's lock those in place. What did I come up here for? Steel. Right. Steel. There we go. You know what? I'm actually going to increase this. I want 2 stacks now. Okay. Because I'm just going to crank these out. There. Actually, just enough to feed in here. So yeah, I'm doing a lot better. I'm surprised I haven't been attacked yet. I think I got a really good spawn. A lot of pollution is being trapped by the... I mean, you can see the forest right here is trapping the pollution. So, it's just a matter of time, because they're going to keep getting closer and closer. My pollution is going to keep going further and further out. I want 5 more of those. I'm going to want 5 chemical plants. Okay, so... the way that we're going to work this is we're going to have a... there we go. Do-do-do-do-do. You are going to unload empty crude. We have our one pipe. We're going to rotate... darn it. There we go. Okay, so we're going to have our one pipe here. We're going to have an input and an output. The input is on the bottom. So, bottom, top. There we go. Input, output. Input. Output's there. So we need power. And white in here. So now, this is going to extract the oil and cram it in here. And I do not want to put it into tanks because I just want it, I want the barrels to be the... Yeah. Do I want tanks, actually? Well, I mean... Yeah, let's do some tanks. Let's do just 2. 2's good. So, there we go. Okay. Now, we want a pipe here. And in fact, I'm going to do this just for expansion purposes. And I want my oil refinery... here, and you are going to do basic. So let's get power over to our oil refinery. And I violated my own rule. Pipe. There we go. Okay. There we go. We are now refining oil with basic. This produces petroleum gas, light oil, and heavy oil, or whatever it is. Let's see. Yeah, heavy oil, petroleum gas, light oil. Okay, so I want to split these out and do stuff with them. I know that's a technical term, but yay. Now, the nice thing about having my steel line right here is I can actually... Did I space it right? No, I didn't. If I were one more over, or... I could be right there. Ha-ha! So you are going to make... No. Maybe. Well, I'm... Here I am being indecisive again. Darn it. Okay, we need our sulfur production. Okay, so let us put this right here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to have an inserter here and an output there. We're going to have a steel chest there. Where's our steel chest? I need more steel chests. Okay. You are going to make barrels. Now, the reason I'm not feeding into this one is because I do not want to limit the output here. At the same time, I do want to limit the output here because I don't want to make infinity of these. But now I can take these empty barrels, and this is going to be labor-intensive, running back and forth. But run down here, and then drop off those, pick up these. And now I'm just building up a stock of barrels, and eventually I'll have it enough. And that's why I wanted to limit that one output. Oop, there we go. So we can put this here, and there's more crude coming out. Excellent. So, we've got the beginnings of the petroleum fields started. Next time, I will work on breaking these out. We'll probably work... I think I'm just going to beeline to robots. Anything that I need to do to get robots, that's what I am going to do. I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I will see you next time. Have fun!